Over 16 million U.S. armed forces served in World War II. They said they just did what needed to be done, but we will always be humbled by their courage, their patriotism, and their unswerving dedication. Over 400,000 Americans sacrificed their lives, and more than 600,000 were injured across six continents and every ocean. Our gratitude to these brave souls has no bounds. Over the decades, most of the GI generation have left us. Of the 1,400,000 remaining World War II veterans, 680 leave us every day. Last year, our dear friend Charles Durning was one of them. Charles Durning was a truly gifted actor, appearing on Broadway, television, and some of Hollywood's most memorable films. He was the recipient of a Tony, two Academy Award nominations, 9 Primetime Emmy nominations, and the Screen Actors Guild Lifetime Achievement Award. Yet, it is his service as a young private in World War II, his Silver Star, Bronze Star, and 3 Purple Hearts that we remember tonight. Year after year, he was a stalwart supporter of our nation's Memorial Day concert. He was a member of our family. He represented the courage and resiliency of World War II's GI generation. And for 15 years on this stage, he expressed his support for all veterans everywhere. Charlie rarely talked about his own military service. He once told an interviewer, "I don't want you to see me crying." But in 2004, he did speak on this stage of his experience as a 21-year-old facing a baptism by fire on D-Day, on the first wave at Omaha Beach.
It's hard to describe what we all went through that day, but those of us who were there will understand. We were frightened all the time. My sergeant said, "Are you scared, son?" And I said, "Yes, I am." And he said, "That's good. It's good to be scared." He said, "We all are." We got behind this tank to protect ourselves. We were holding our own when they called us over to them. I asked the sergeant, "Do you want me to go first or would you go first?" He said, "You go first, I'll be right behind you." I heard an explosion and turned around, and his torso was here and his body was over there. And there was another guy whose intestines were out on the sand in front of him, and he was still alive. And he seemed to be very calm. You know, when someone's dying, you can see it right away. Everything changes in their face. It's kind of gray. He said, "I can't go home like this. How are they going to push all that back into me?" I saw wounded guys dying crawl up to the front of us to act as barricades so they could protect us from getting hit with their own bodies. I saw that. They would come up and just lay there, you know, take the shot. Once we got up to the bluff, you could see for miles. There was this eerie sight of bodies which looked like driftwood floating in the water. The beach was covered with the bodies of American soldiers. And all of these things are like flashbacks for me. I can't recall everything. I forget a lot of the stuff now. But I still wake up once in a while, and it's still there. I can't count how many of my buddies are in the cemetery at Normandy. The heroes are still there. The real heroes.
A week after D-Day, Charlie was severely wounded, but returned to combat in time to take part in the Battle of the Bulge. He and his buddies were ambushed and most of them killed, but Charlie fought back, and it was for his relentless bravery that he would be awarded the Silver Star and one of his Purple Hearts. At war's end, He participated in the liberation of what was then called a prison camp.
Most of us who lived through that profound human tragedy don't speak of it very often. Even now, after more than 50 years, the memories carry horror and grief beyond all words or feelings. Yet it's so important not to forget, for it is in the remembering, however painful, that we bear the seeds of hope for a better tomorrow. Our memory is a holy ground, cruelly sanctified by the blood not only of the 6 million Jews and 5 million others who died in those death camps, but also of the more than 40 million other men, women, and children whose lives were brutally ended in that war. 300,000 of those deaths were our American soldiers, including a lot of my buddies. We do remember. We will not forget. Somewhere in the holy ground of our memories, in a way more mysterious and sacred than we can understand, every one of these precious human lives has a resting place. May they rest in peace.
On February 21st, 2013, Charles Durney was buried with military honors at Arlington National Cemetery.
Michelle, Doug, Janine, on behalf of the President of the United States Army, and a grateful nation, please accept this flag as a symbol of our appreciation for your father's service. From a grateful nation, bless you all.
Charlie, we will never forget you. May you rest in peace. In honor of Charles Durning and all his fallen buddies, world-renowned tenor Ronan Tynan, accompanied by the National Symphony Orchestra.